Have you ever wondered what one magician's favorite card trick might be and why that is one of their favorite tricks? I've been a full-time magician since 2014, which feels like forever right now as I'm talking about this. And if we're just meeting, my name is Caroline Ravn. As I said, I'm a full-time magician and, well, now I guess YouTuber as well. And one thing that I've noticed is that we keep coming back to the same tricks that we really, really enjoy doing. One trick I really like to perform, or one type of trick, I guess you can call it, or a method, something's called a sandwich. That is basically when you have one selected card, or more, sandwiched, well, trapped in between two other cards. From magicians, I guess the trick that people ask me most about is the sandwich routine that I perform and where the magic happens. So a while back, I decided to do a magic course where I teach some of the tricks that I actually perform on a regular basis. And one of the tricks that I teach is the sandwich routine that I do. The course has been very well received and I'm really, really happy to say so. And I wanted to share just one trick with you guys. So this is actually from the course, directly taken from the course. Consider this video some sort of a sample of what the course is. This is also a really good breakdown of what's going on, how it works, and why I do the things that I do in the trick. So when you're watching this video and when you learn how to perform this, I do encourage you to actually just learn how it's done, learn the mechanics, try to find a way to make it more you, because we see so many magicians out there who just take a trick, do exactly what they saw that other magician do, and they just copy it. And I think that's such a shame because we have so much more to give. If you do have the opportunity to just sit down and figure out who you are as a magician, who you are as a performer, it's gonna be so much easier for you to actually take this trick and any other trick and implement it into your show. Well, enough about that. I do hope you're gonna enjoy this video. And as you're watching this, I do encourage you to also bring out a deck of cards and follow along in this tutorial of how this actually works. I also included a link in the description below where you can go find the course as well. Please let me know in the comments below which trick you would like to learn or what method or theory you would like me to talk about in future videos. In this video, I'm gonna teach you how to do one of my favorite sandwich routines. A sandwich routine is when a selected card is connected inside a couple of cards. Normally, it is one selected card between either two jokers or two kings or whatever you want it to be. And the trick looks like this.
All right, Marcus, I've been holding the cards this entire time, so I would like you now to freely select any card you'd like, take it out, make sure you like it. If you don't, put it back in, choose another one. Mm-hmm, absolutely. Anyone except that one. I'm kidding.
This is mine.
Double check, make sure you like it.
Okay, yeah.
Are you happy?
Yeah.
You're happy, good. Please show it to the camera as well. Mm-hmm. I think they got it.
Yeah.
If they don't, they just have to, you know, trust you, yeah. I guess. And now, tell me when to stop before I'm done.
Stop.
Put it back. Please remember the card.
Yep.
Good. Now. I want you to examine the jokers. Make sure they are what they seem. They are not magnetic. There are no threads attached to them. No, good. All right. Now, which one do you like the better? The bird or the cat?
I don't like cats.
Oh, you like the raven. Nice, me too. Let's put them right there. Now. You do remember your card, yes?
Yeah.
Give me a number between 1 and 5.
2.
2. Okay. I'm gonna take 2 seconds. I was hoping for a 5. I'm gonna take 2 seconds to memorize this entire deck of cards. Would you be impressed? Please say yes.
I would please.
That would be impossible. That'd be impossible, you guys. 2 seconds. 2 seconds. Okay. You're gonna have to start counting when I say now, okay?
Yeah.
And you go 1001, 1002, yeah, otherwise I can't do
yeah,
it.
Of course.
Yeah,
of course.
Okay. Start now.
1001, 1002.
Woo-hoo-hoo. What was your card?
Four of diamonds.
The four of diamonds is in position 33 from the top. Not only that, I'm gonna take the cards. I'm gonna take the Raven Joker and the Cat Joker. Go through all of the cards, find the four of diamonds at position 33. Right there. It's like a lottery ticket, isn't it? Or a car crash, you can't really look away. You kind of want to go closer, double check and see what's up, but you know, anyone can do it really. Of course you can. Or you could just leave it right there and just, you know, hope that it, I mean, it would be impossible. I'm not Harry Potter.
Well.
You can check. Of Thank you so much, Marcus.
You're amazing.
As you saw in the video, we're doing a overhand shuffle, we're doing a break, and all of the stuff that we've been going through. So let's move through how this is actually achieved. You have them select a card. We're gonna make this simple for us. We're gonna use the gimmicked card. This is their selected card. Then you do this where you riffle the cards down. So you riffle it down, you ask them to say stop here. They take their selected card, place it here. You have a break, put the cards on top. Now you cut the cards, you see here, same as before. You cut the cards twice, you have their selected card here. Now the card is on the top. We want this card on the bottom. So we shuffle, we do the overhand shuffle like this. At this point, we have no idea what the card is. We shuffle and we make sure that we see the bottom card. So now I've seen it. If I'm not certain, I can just do this and I already know what it is. Now you take the jokers or aces or kings or whatever you want to use and you place them like this. So you have them facing up and the rest of the cards facing down. And the idea now is to get them to understand how impossible it would be for you to find their selected card. I use this as a look how fast I can memorize a deck of cards, even though that is total, you know, that's not what's happening at all. But I like that presentation where it's like, okay, give me a number between 1 and 5, 3. Okay, perfect. I'm gonna do this memory thing of the deck in 3 seconds. And I'm not at all. So I have the cards like this, so I get ready in the position. So I show them that I hold it like this, the deck like this, with my ring and long finger here and my thumb on the other side. And then with my left hand, I just slide their card out like this. See that? So they can see that we have one joker on the bottom and one on top. And how I hold it now is with my thumb here and my fingers here on the cards in the back. So I'm still holding on to the edges of that card. Repurpose your hand, take your right hand, and hold it like this, where you have your thumb on top, and you see how the other joker is resting on your hand, and your long finger is now connected to their selected card. So now we're gonna use friction to get the card in the position that we want. So we're gonna toss the deck from hand to hand, squeezing with our thumb here, not too much, with our thumb here, our long finger under here, making sure that we have that connected to the selected card. So as we toss this, you see that their card is now still in touch with our long finger, like this, because of friction. Let's do that one more time. Their selected card on the bottom. We have the jokers here. We have the finger in the position that we want. And you see here what happens. See that? With friction. But this looks amazing when you do this up to speed. So let's do it one more time. We have their selected card, toss. You show that their card is in fact in between. You either let it go here or you take it out. I like to ask them to do it themselves because it's an impossible situation and you're gonna have so many people's minds blown with this trick. This is one of my absolute favorites. I do it every show that I do and you're gonna have so much fun with this. All right, so that is the sandwich routine that I perform like literally every show that I do. I've also done a version of this on online shows and it's been really well received and people are absolutely loving it. So I do hope you loved it too and I do hope you're gonna have so much fun both performing and practicing this trick. If you did in fact get any value of this video, please make sure to like it. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, make sure to do so and turn on those notifications so you don't miss when the next video is coming out. All right, that's it for today. I do hope you enjoyed it and I will see you in the next video. Bye!